Welcome to the second part of a two-part tutorial where we figure out how to get better than raw colors out of the GH5, this camera. If you want to see the previous episode, click here. On that episode, we went through how to set up your camera, how to expose, and how to shoot this. This is a color target that we're going to use in this episode. We're going to use this, the footage that we shot of this, we're going to use it to create a color hack or color calibration file. Okay, so let's start. And by the way, be warned, this is rather advanced stuff, so I will go quite quickly. So if you need any clarification, just ask and I will reply. Okay, let's jump right into Photoshop. And yes, I do my advanced color work in Photoshop. It's out of the scope of this tutorial to teach you how to use Photoshop for video color work, though I have a webinar coming about it, so I'm gonna talk about it in the end of this tutorial. Okay, let's continue. Here on Photoshop, I have a raw photo on the right and a frame from vlog video file on the left. And by the way, this is actually a good tip. When you're shooting video, you can switch your camera to still mode, grab one raw photo and switch it back to video. So this is because then you have a raw photo to compare your colors to. The raw colors are often really good because raw photo has metadata embedded in it. So the computer knows how to translate the colors. So then you have a reference image of how the color should look, at least very close one. Okay, so in the Photoshop we have the same situation. We have a raw photo for reference, and on the left we have a frame from vlog video file that we're gonna try to match the colors to the right. And here I have four lookup tables that are meant to translate vlog colors and vlog contrast to Rec 709. So basically making it look normal. And if you want to know more about this log raw Rec 709, Rec 2020, Gamma and Gamut kind of things, you can click here because I made a video to explain these concepts. And I really recommend you watching it because when you understand these formats, you can really use the power of them. Okay, anyway, let's continue. So here we have four lookup tables and let's try them on individually. The first one is from this guy who creates these lookup tables for color grading. And this is how it looks with this transformation lookup table, a translation lookup table. And here you can see that they don't really match. The skin tones are magenta and the background is very bluish grayish. So I don't really like this one. Here on the second one, this is actually from the official Panasonic website. So this is the official Panasonic translation lookup table. And it doesn't really look good because the skin tones are still a bit magenta and the background is really grayish. So I don't really like that. The second one is Cinema 5D, a very famous camera blog, and you can see that this lookup table is best out of these three, but it's still very different when we compare it to the raw file. So I don't really like that either. The fourth one is from a software called Lutkalk. This is a free software that is meant for creating these translation lookup tables. So this is actually, out of these four, this looks the best. This is closest to the raw file. So I'm gonna use this as the base for our hack. And I actually did the hack already. So let's see how the hack looks. And here is the color hack. And you can see that this, out of these four, this is the closest to the raw file. And actually when I look at this, I really think that the left one looks even better than the raw one. So this is why I call better than raw color hack. Of course, if I would make a calibration file for the raw file, then the raw file would look even better. But the idea was to compare the calibrated vlog to uncalibrated raw, and I really like the vlog better. Okay, so next I'm gonna teach you how to create this hack. And by the way, before we continue doing the hack, let me show you that I created a hack for the cinelike-d as well. So here you can see the image straight out of the camera with cinelike-d, and here the same image with hack, and you can see that it compares better to the raw file. Okay, let's continue. So short recap. Last time I explained the idea of this. This is a color target, and we know the RGB values of each of these chips. And based on the information that we have, that how the colors look in the video file and how they should look, based on that information, we can create this hack. And that's just the thing that we're gonna do next. And I want to say, tell you that you don't actually have to follow, you can just skip this part if you want, because I'm gonna give you the hack, so you don't have to do this. But if you are interested, let's go. Here on Photoshop, I have a frame from a video shot in Vlog with this color target, and the color target is exposed the way that I explained you in the last video. So first, let's apply the lookup table that gets us closest to where we want to be. And then I'm gonna do the color hack. And for the color hack, and I'm actually going to use this software. This is a 3D LUT creator, and based on the name, as you can see, this is a software where you can do color grading and color calibration and color correction in three dimensions. So this is very powerful software. Rather unintuitive first, but then when you get hang of it, you're like, you're flying. Okay, anyway, so let's bring the photo from the image from Photoshop to this software. And then I'm gonna use this grid tool that we already have in this software. And I'm gonna place this this grid. I'm gonna align it with these chips. Then, because this was overexposed, I'm gonna tell it how much it was overexposed, and it already knows that it's 0.9. Tell it that it was 0.9 stops overexposed. So this will update the grid on how the grid should look if it was overexposed. And then we're gonna match the curves. So we're gonna match the gray parts, the gray gray part of the grid to the gray chips. So let's just do that match. And already we can see that the colors look much better when the color cast and the contrast was corrected. And this number here already tells us that we are really close to what the color should be. So let's look under the hood what's happening. So here on the curves tab, we can see that it corrected the color cast, and then it increased contrast. It brought the blacks. It crushed the blacks and clipped the highlights. And that's something that we don't actually want to happen. So I'll just release the top part of this curve, recover the dynamic range that was lost. So now we have it, and you can see the number actually got worse. But don't worry, this part was just to save the dynamic range. Then the next part is that we're going to kind of reset this. So we're going to reset this software with these colors. I don't want to explain. Anyway, and then we're going to use this tool. Here we have these lines. Actually, I have to use this HSP model instead of the HSPE model, because it for some reason doesn't work. Here we have these white lines, and on the other end of the white line we have a cross, and that's where it should be, and the other side of the white color indicates where it's currently. So now I'll just start warping the color space so that so this is warping the color space, so we are creating the hack to get better color out of GH5. Okay, let's start. And keep an eye on for this number. This is the number that tells how close we are to the colors, how the color should be. Okay, so we got 5.68. That's a rather good number, though last time I got even better. So next we import this LUT to Photoshop. And here on Photoshop you can see that we have now two lookup tables stacked on top of each other. The lower one, this one, is from the software LUTCalc, and the top one is from the software 3D LUT created, the one that we just created. By themselves, neither is any good, but when we stack them together, then we get the better than raw colors out of the Vlog profile. So next we'll simply go File, Export, and Color Lookup Tables. We're exporting one lookup table. We're kind of like combining these two and exporting them as one. So it's easy for you to download the hack and use it as a one lookup table in any software you want. But because I did this process already from a bit better image of the color checker, I got even closer with the colors. So let's just use that. Next, let's put our hack to the test. I'll open Premiere Pro, and here I have timeline full of footage that I shot for the last episode, all shot in Vlog. So to apply the hack in Premiere Pro, I use the Lumetri panel, And in the Lumetri panel, I use the creative tab, not this input LUT, but the creative tab here. And I just simply apply the LUT. The reason is that now I can use these white balance sliders to correct the white balance of the footage before I put it through the translation. Or if I've overexposed it too much, I could use the white slider or the exposure slider to correct it a bit. Though the Lumetri panel is rather limited when it comes to accurately correcting log footage, but you can eyeball it. And if you want to do precise color corrections for log footage, you can do it in Photoshop, and I will teach it in the future webinar / YouTube live. So when you download this hack, you will be notified. But let's continue. So now that we have applied the LUT, I can simply copy this effect and paste it to other footage that I have on the timeline. So it's rather simple from now on. And for example, like if I would think, for example, this footage, it's a bit underexposed, I could go to the basic tab and bring it up a bit. So the next phase is that if I would like to create a look for the footage, I like to grade the footage. Normally we would use the Lumetri panel's creative tab for grading the footage, but it's already used because we are using for the translation. So I'll copy this effect. So now we have like a fresh copy of the effect. Though now it's messing up the colors because it's trying to translate the colors twice, but let's just reset this. So now we have the Lumetri panel ready to use for grading purposes. For example, the creative tab is now empty because the translation happens on the previous Lumetri color effect. So for example, I could give it a bit more contrast, I could crush the blacks and raise up the shadows and give more saturation, whatever you want. And then I could even apply a grading LUT, for example the Cine Space, because I really like this one, though not so strong, so I would put it to 20% or something like this. So now we have a corrected, translated and graded footage. Okay, now I would like to throw the ball to you. If you have a GH5, shoot something with the guidelines that I gave you in the previous episode. This one, you can click here to see it. Then try to apply this hack / LUT file to your footage and tell me, what do you think? Is it better than RAW? I'm really interested to see how it works. For example, how it works with high ISO and how it works with artificial lighting, especially with low CRI lamps. So next, load the hack with the link in the description of this video. I'll send it to you. And about the webinar / YouTube live that I mentioned, how to use Photoshop for video color grading. When I send you the hack, I can then notify you when the webinar YouTube live is due, so you won't miss it. So load the hack next and use it. Okay, so there we have it, at the end of this tutorial. And remember, if you have any questions, drop me a comment and I'll reply. See you in the next one. Bye.